Hi, welcome back to the channel Chief Engineers Tea Time Talk. I am Ramesh and I'll be your pilot who will guide you through this channel. And before I commence, thank you so much for your kind words of appreciation for my previous video. In this session, I am going to talk to you about rudder carrier bearing. But before I commence, I just want you to introspect on one small thing. This is regarding the cartoon which I am putting it up. You have a look at it for more than 20-30 seconds, have a really hard look at it, you will realize that it has almost conveyed the entire concept of the rudder carrier bearing. We don't need this 4 minutes of talk or 2 pages of A4 sheets to be filled up. This cartoon conveys everything, in fact. This cartoon is such a powerful medium of communication, but unfortunately, because it has traditionally been used for humor, so it has never been taken seriously. It is like a joker in a circus or a comedian in a film. Even if the joker is doing the best of acrobatics or the comedian is doing the best of acting and conveying a very powerful message, he is always looked at as a joker or as a comedian, never taken seriously. So this is a fact. But if you can look beyond that and look at the cartoon, it will be a tool for you to remember that concept throughout your life. Let me tell you, you will never forget. But another piece of small advice for my junior friends, though cartoon is a great piece of tool to remember, please, when you go for your exam and the surveyor asks you this question, please do not draw a cartoon. Okay, that is not done. Okay, keep watching. The next topic which we are going to pick up for today is the rudder drop. Now, don't get confused with the rudder drop of the last video. That was a defect. It was an accident, a calamity. This is a proper rudder drop, right? So now, how can the rudder drop? Before we answer, go ahead and answer this question. Let us see where is the weight of the rudder stock and the rudder coming on. You see the rudder connected to the stock, the entire thing, you see this, is now actually sitting on this piece of bearing metal. See here, see, the rudder is sitting on this. Now we call this as the rudder carrier bearing. This one, this is a rudder carrier bearing. It is carrying the weight, so we call it the carrier bearing. Okay, so now if this bearing gets worn out, correct, have a look here. If this bearing gets worn out, obviously the rudder is going to drop. Correct. So now, this is again, we have just seen the concept about jumping clearance. Exactly the same thing is going to happen. It's just the opposite. If the rudder drops, obviously the tillers, the top part of the tiller is going to come and touch the ram, and this should not happen. That means the wear down of the rudder carrier bearing has to be within permissible limits, and the criteria for the permissible limit is such that this clearance should not vanish. So that is the significance of a rudder drop. Rudder drop is nothing but it indicates the wear down of this bearing, which is a carrier bearing. This drop in the rudder obviously needs to be measured. It is usually done at the time of docking and a report made. So basically, how do you measure this is, you have something called a Trammel gauge. You fit the Trammel gauge, one end of the Trammel gauge bears on the rudder stock tip, a dedicated marked point on the rudder stock, and the other end is basically, it is supposed to go and coincide with the fixed dedicated marking on at a point on the ship's hull or usually a girder. This is marked at the time of ship's delivery, and then every time the ship goes for docking, people do keep comparing this marks and by putting the gauge. So the logic is, if the rudder has dropped, obviously you can see that this gauge has dropped from that mark, original mark. So anyway, this is of academic interest, but as a watchkeeping engineer, what is in our hand which is more effective than this is, since you know the concept, you are going to check the clearance here. So if you keep checking the clearance and you see that there is enough reasonable clearance, then you actually need not worry too much about this, because this is what really matters.
have a better look at the carrier bearing. Okay, now this is the sliding surface, rotating surface. Look at this. This is the carrier ring, which has got the surface which is going to sit on the bearing surface. Correct. Normally it is keyed. This carrier ring is keyed, and then that means with the stock is turning, the carrier ring is turning, and then the whole weight is sitting on this. And this is rotary and this is static. The bearing is not moving, but whereas the carrier is moving. And then you have all the other things like gland packings and all that. So anyway, now again we are going to ask the same question, that what is the significance of a rudder drop in the rotary vane steering gear. You see that here we have a rudder carrier bearing and a bearing metal has been provided, but in a rotary vane steering gear, as far as my observations go, for having seen so many of them in the last so many years, most of the designs, they actually provide you a bearing metal in the bottom cover itself, thereby eliminating the need for a rudder carrier bearing. So don't be surprised if your ship doesn't have a rudder carrier bearing. You be aware that the rudder carrier bearing is there, which is the bottom cover of the rotary vane steering gear, and a special metal which is designed to take the weight. And also, of course, lubrication is not at all a problem because it is full of oil. So that is provided in the bottom cover of the rotary vane steering gear. Now, if you are curious and you try to compare, if you have a wear out of the rudder carrier bearing metal in a 4-ram steering gear, it doesn't really harm the performance of the steering gear, except that you are increasing the risk. This clearance gear at the top is reducing till it comes and creates a big damage. So you can take corrective action before this happens, but till this touches, there is no great appreciable deterioration in the performance of the steering. But in a rotary vane steering gear, if this bearing is wearing out, which can happen because of dirty oil, correct, that means the rudder starts dropping. Drop of even a half a millimeter is going to start telling on the performance of the steering gear, because the clearance between the top cover and the rotor is increasing. The more the drop, there is immediate reflection on the performance, in the deteriorated performance of the steering gear, whereas in a 4-ram steering gear, there is no deterioration in performance because of a wear out of a rudder carrier bearing till there is a problem on the tiller arm. About the hydraulics part of 4-ram and steering gear, we will definitely have to cater for another video completely, or maybe a few more videos, because I want to keep the videos short, cannot have a video stretching for 1 hour. So we'll look at it in future.
Subscribe for the channel to get notified about the upcoming videos, and also do not hesitate to put in those small pieces of appreciation or comment. These are the things which keep me motivated. Anyway, take care, stay safe, see you in the next video. Till then, goodbye, let me sign off. Thank you.